A common complaint of the neurotic or depressed is that they don't feel whole. It is as if a piece of them is missing or perhaps was never there at all. Such an issue was of direct interest to the psychoanalyst Carl Jung, whose complex theory of personality argued for the use of depth psychology and dream analysis to put the pieces of self back together. This process he named individuation. What is it exactly? I can find myself guilty of only clicking links that I agree with. Sometimes this is an innocent confirmation of my own beliefs, or perhaps fuel for an argument over gluten or intermittent fasting or something else entirely trivial. But sometimes this habit blinds me from the other side of the story, and sometimes it keeps me from hearing the story entirely. Whether you agree with the other side or not, it's at least a good idea to hear them out from time to time. Thankfully, there's Ground News to break the bubble. The world's first news comparison platform that empowers readers to see how sources with different perspectives cover the same story. Ground News is an app with two main features. For one, there's the News Blind Spot feature, which allows you to see the news that isn't being discussed by one side of the political spectrum. Secondly, there's the News Comparison feature, which helps you easily compare different sources that are covering the same story. It should be stated that Ground News is not a fact checker. Instead, it empowers you to come to your own informed decision by showing you all of the information available. This is thanks to the fact that Ground News has over 50,000 news outlets from across the world and across the political spectrum. And fortunately, Ground News doesn't use predatory algorithms that take in your browsing history to determine which news articles you can see. If you would like to escape the algorithm bubble and be more informed on news, Ground News is right for you. Individuation is the primary goal of analytical psychology, and commonly occurs in the second half of one's life. Simply put, it is the process by which the individual becomes psychologically whole, or becomes oneself. The self, for Jung, is different from the ego. Whereas the ego is the conscious self focused on identity and continuity, the self is the unification of the conscious with the unconscious. He theorized that we emerge as babies with a unified self, but that this is minimized and silenced as the ego soon develops. This is an important step, establishing oneself as a stable identity in the external world. Jung names this process in the first half of life, ego differentiation. However, there comes a time in which the personality is injured or challenged. Jung himself experienced a series of mental issues and a sense of spiritual alienation after he and Freud grew apart. The only cure to such neuroses is a return to the self of youth, the resituation of the self at the center of personality. This involves a confrontation with the varying unconscious elements within one's personality. These elements include the anima and animus, the persona and the shadow. The anima and animus are what Jung considered to be the opposing masculine and feminine forces within the unconscious. The anima is the perception-based feminine unconscious in men, and the animus is the judgment-based masculine unconscious in women. Each acts as a guide to the unconscious if the self is unified. However, if not unified, these forces tend to project themselves onto others in order to draw attention. Jung theorized that this is the reason why we sometimes feel immediately attracted to strangers, as we are projecting our anima and animus onto them. He also believed that those who appear rigid in their gender roles and appear uncomfortable acting outside of them likely have failed to recognize their anima or animus. The persona is the mask we wear throughout our social experience. As Jung writes, the persona is the individual's system of adaptation to or the manner assumed in dealing with the world. Every calling or profession, for example, has its own persona. One could say with little exaggeration that the persona is that which in reality one is not, but which oneself as well as others think one is. Of course, if we fail to recognize that the persona is little more than an act, we may fall into it entirely and fail to ever feel true to ourselves. It is important, then, that we recognize its influence through this process of individuation. Finally, there is the shadow, the aspect of the unconscious that the ego has entirely repressed, for it represents all of the things that we have disowned about ourselves. Those who are gentle will have a brutal shadow, and those who are prudent will have a libertine shadow. These aspects are shameful and sometimes harmful to us, as they may destroy our sense of self entirely. However, they may also be constructive in what Jung defines as gold in the shadow, or positive aspects that we may deny despite their capacity to push us towards feeling whole. Jung also believes it is important to know one's shadow so that we may avoid projecting it onto others, a common defense mechanism referenced in psychoanalysis time and time again. There is a specific methodology usually undertaken with the supervision of a therapist that brings forth individuation. Firstly, the patient's ego is assessed to determine whether one is capable of withstanding the intensity of the process, as the ego tends to be rigid and antagonistic to that which challenges its representation of identity. Such a process can be quite difficult. Afterwards, we generally see a period of confession and catharsis, where one admits that there is a destructive pattern to their personality that isn't working. The addict, for example, may admit that they do in fact have some responsibility over their addiction, or perhaps the traumatized must recognize that the past is unchanging. This process is painful and can lead to neurosis. However, it is also a period of cleansing, where the possibility of change reveals itself. The patient then undergoes analysis while under some form of neuroses. This step, commonly named elucidation, involves the exploration of one's dreams as well as free association. Here we see Jung's depth psychology at play, specifically his interest in the collective unconscious in order to understand the imagery behind our emotions. As he writes, it is the matrix of all conscious psychic occurrences, and hence it exerts an influence that compromises the freedom of consciousness in the highest degree, since it is continuously striving to lead all conscious processes back into the old paths. The patient may then experience some relief through elucidation as they discover the meaning behind their suffering. This step, called education, involves creative play and the introduction of new ways of being. Solutions are formed to specifically deal with the problem at hand. Finally, the patient is sent into the real world. Their consciousness, filled with large amounts of new information about their personality, will slowly integrate with aspects of the unconscious. The final step is named transformation and takes a significant amount of time. Nonetheless, it allows for one to integrate their previously repressed unconscious elements and perhaps feel whole. Jung notes that individuation is not a process that necessarily ends, however. The instability and fluidity of the unconscious means that we will never truly be whole. Nonetheless, an ordering principle has developed that is far more integrative and holistic than the previous ego. This is the product of individuation. Much of this may sound like New Age spiritualism mixed with cryptic analytical terminology, and perhaps it is, but the articulate and complex theory that Jung developed still inspires those to this day, and much of his language is regularly equipped to describe neuroses. Whether there are archetypes, shadows, or animals is perhaps beside the point. Carl Jung offered us a system of thought that appears to intimately capture our need for meaning behind suffering and a sense of unity in spite of alienation.